Imagine you're on vacation on the Canary Islands. It's a beautiful sunny day, you're out for a swim, and you're looking for some beautiful fish. And then you spot one, in the far distance. But the closer you get, you realize it's just a plastic bottle. And there's another one, and another one. Unfortunately, this is the reality we already live in today, and as a recent study has shown, the plastic which is visibly floating on top of the ocean is just a small fraction, just about 10% of the overall amount of plastic which we've released to the ocean. So we're really just seeing the tip of the iceberg here. And the big problem about this is that plastic is such a durable material that once it's released to the environment, it's going to remain there for hundreds of years. So what can we do about it? Well, potentially the answer to this question is hidden in the so-called cyanobacteria. You can see a microscopic picture of them on this slide. They are small green little bugs which have essentially two cool features. The first one is that they're able to grow with the help of photosynthesis, meaning they can use the energy provided by the sun to actively sequester CO2 from the atmosphere and incorporate it into their metabolism. That's why they're also sometimes referred to as microalgae. The second cool feature about cyanobacteria is that under certain environmental conditions, they can use this carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and convert it into a biopolymer called PHB. And the reason why I'm so fascinated about this is because PHB is a new form of biodegradable bioplastic, which has superior material properties, while at the same time it's easily biodegradable once it's released to the environment. The only drawback was that naturally cyanobacteria produce only very small amounts of this PHB. So I had to become the bacteria engineer. Throughout this process, I further investigated the different pathways, how the CO2 is traveling through the cell until it's finally converted into our bioplastic. And once I understood those pathways, I was able to specifically reroute them, to redesign them in such a way that the carbon dioxide is straight converted into bioplastic. The results of this you can see on the bottom of my slide. Here you have electron microscopic pictures of the cyanobacterial cells. And within those cells, you have these small white granules. That's the bioplastic PHB. And you can see that through my engineering approach, I was able to drastically increase the amount of bioplastic within those cells. So, long story short, throughout my research at the University of Tübingen, I designed and constructed biological machines for the production of sustainable products, which will help us to protect our environment and to mitigate climate change.